Whatever you do, in word or in deed, do it all in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, giving thanks to God the Father. That is Colossians 3, verse 17. It's worth memorizing. It is really the centerpiece of the whole book. How does that work? That's what we're going to talk about. But first, I'd love for you to describe for the group your home, what your home looks like now, and what it looked like growing up. Who lives in a home? Who comes for holidays? Is your family loud, orderly, a little bit nuts? Share a little insight, a behind the curtain peek at your home today and what your home was like growing up. Okay, so we're reading here in Colossians 3 about how a household is supposed to operate, how husbands are supposed to treat their wives, wives their husbands, parents, kids, workers in the business. These are called household codes. It's a familiar genre in Greco-Roman literature. It's just kind of, hey, here's how life is supposed to be lived in the home. And so what I'd like for you to do is read some other household codes that come straight from the Apostle Paul and the Apostle Peter. We're going to read three of them, Colossians 3, Ephesians 5, and 1 Peter 2. And so after reading those passages together, what are the household roles common to all three of these household codes? Okay, having looked at what the scriptures say about how households operate, obviously we live in a modern world and we might have a few differences. The core of the Bible doesn't change, but some of our habits and practices and cultural nuances will. So share with the group, I want to get practical here. What roles do you have in your family? Does the father stay at the head of the table? Is it the mom who does the cooking? Those are traditional roles. Do the kids take out the trash? What are the roles in your family, and how do these roles help create health and stability in your home? We mentioned last week that every human relationship is designed to model a spiritual relationship. So a father and son is God's role with you. Father, daughter, God's role with you. Husband, wife, Christ, his relationship with the church. So here's the question for us right now. How do the relationships in your home help model the relationship of Christ and his church in your community? Believe it or not, your home is a mini church in your neighborhood. So, what does your family do to make Jesus famous in that community? A lot of groups take the summer off, which is totally okay, but I really want to encourage you to stay connected. And what we're finding is that those who are new in the community or those who are separate from Christ have more interest in a service project for the community than even going to church. It used to be that your first ask was to come to CCV. I'm wondering if for you, maybe your first ask isn't to a service project in the community. And how cool would it be if when new neighbors come in, you connect them immediately to some people in your group before ever inviting them to CCV? That is how to win the Valley for Christ.